Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you a new tips, that is how you can download and install the Spring Tool Suite 4 in Windows. So before getting started, what is the prerequisite to do this installation? So yeah, we go here. If we go to the website, to the spring.io website, here the requirement will be to have at least the JDK 8 installed, and to check a version of Java installed, here we go to the CMD, and if you tap Java's hyphen versions, here you can see that the requirement, what I have here is the OpenJDK versions 11. Yeah, then we fit the requirement. And the second thing is to have a 64 versions of the operating system. So if you have a 32-bit version of the operating system, then that will not work. So these are the two major requirements that I will put here on board. Then next, after the requirement is fulfilled, what you have to do is to go here to Google or your favorite search engine, then type STS4 download, and if we tap here, we are presented with this page. Then we click here, then here is the page. Then if we scroll here, you can see here, depending to the version of the your operating system, then you choose what you want. Here we don't have Linux, we don't have Mac, we have Windows 10 64-bit. Then sorry, what we have to do is to click here, and the jar file will be downloaded. Here it takes around 1 minute to get it done. Speed is downloading. Let's wait for a while. 53 30 seconds is downloading. So then I assume that you already have the JDK. If you don't know how to do that, you can search it, or you can see one of my video how to download the JDK. Then it will be coming, it will be coming, it will be coming. We still have few seconds to have it. We are almost there. Bam! After install, here you are presented with these two options here. Do you want to discard it or to keep it, because our system detects this as a harmful applications, because it's a jar, executable jar file. So what we click here do is we click on keep. So we are going to keep it, and now if we click here, show in directory, is presented here. So here is our jar file that we have downloaded, and you are having this icon here because you already have Java installed. Otherwise, you will not have this Java icon here. So what we do here is we right click it, go to properties, and then we unlock, right? Unlock it. Then after unlocking, we right click it and click on. We just open it, or we double click on it. On it, it will take some time. Now we double click on it, then you can see it is extracting. It takes some time, then you extract it, and as soon as you start extracting, we have this SCCS folder that appear here in our directory. It takes some time. Yeah, yeah, 30% is downloading, 60% is still extracting, 70%, 80%, 80%, then almost there at 90%. Then after it's finished here, then we come here and we have here our SES folder. So what we do is that we are going to copy this one. We copy this extracted file and we go in a specific directory here in our computer development and create a folder called SES, and then we paste it, right? We paste it, and then after we paste it, we have this is a content that we copy. We have it inside here, then we can open this one now and come here to Spring Tool Suite 4. You can see the applications, then you double click on that. Then our IDE GUI, graphical user interface, will pop up. Then the first time that it comes with something like this one. So if you don't want to use it, you select here, and this one will come with a different directory. So this is because I already had it before. Then you select where our workspace. We don't want to see this one in the future. Don't ask me again. So then we launch. We are launching. The launch is coming. We take a while. Here is our IDE that has pop up, and then congratulations, you have just successfully downloaded and installed your Spring Boot IDE. Now you can select here to create a Java project or create a Spring starter project or import an existing project, starter projects, or whatever you want. Then if you come here, for example, you may create a new starter project here. You can see here Spring X, depending to what you want to use. You can select the name, you can click here up to the work sets. We go here. Next, you select what you want here, you come back to that, and then bam, finish.
We have our first demo updated, and then you can go on with a new tutorial how you can run your first application. But for this one today, what I wanted to show you is how you could download your applications. You could download SES and install it. I hope that this tutorial has been useful to you, and then if you like it, stay tuned. You click here. And here you allow the access. Starting. Remind me later. So our application is up and running, right? It's up and running. So I will show you in the next tutorial how you could move forward from here. I hope that you like it. Stay tuned. Bye.